小唐创业之路并非一帆风顺，为了替这个家庭多分担一点，小王还是要坚持打两份工，才能维持基本的开销，早上送报纸，下午当保安。日子虽然过得辛苦，但是只要两个人朝着一个方向共同努力，相信他们的日子一定会越过越好。在我们万人看来，和谐融洽的两个人，为什么一提到孩子关系就变得如此尴尬？
晚上小王下班回来已经十点了，小唐的母亲赶紧热好饭菜。吃饭期间，小唐跟小王商量，希望可以领养一个孤儿。
这等你身体好点啊。
我身体现在就行了，四年了还不行吗？
不行。
怎么了？
你身体这样我不放心。
Silhouettes of you are like a taunt. Never really know just what you want. With you I don't ever feel calm. I can feel the sweat inside my palms. Play with me like cats and a string. You don't understand the pain it brings. You don't ever wanna give me wings. You don't ever wanna set me free. You know I'm addicted to you. And it's twisted, you've been gifted with the evil voodoo. Got me coming back for more, even when I've been screwed. Dolls full of pins, pierce my heart straight through. I got issues in my head. I like you in my bed, but you keep me on red. Oh, everything is like a test. I better not text or I'll come off desperate.
But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, baby you'll get sick of being the monster. Out of my head, under my bed, thinking something.
房子掏到手里，就家里家庭的负担。
老人年龄都这么大了，说实在看这样心里很难受，所以我只能说是尽快的努力挣钱，应该让父母去享福了。
从小王的话语中，我们感受到了一个男人作为儿女的自责和无奈。平安夜到了，小唐编了一些苹果准备去夜市摆地摊，但是一到冬天，小唐的腿就开始犯病，疼得厉害，所以小王根本不允许小唐出去。
冬天一冷就疼，也不敢出去。然后今天是平安夜，我也想多编几个苹果，然后晚上出去卖点，在他那下班回来之前我就回来了，他也不知道。